Dorothy is safe.
Anyone could go.
It is really a scary thing.
It's absolutely terrifying.
You just don't know what's going to happen.
We've all got a fight to be here.
There cannot be any mistakes.
There's no other option but to be the best.
Everybody needs to watch her back.
It's really got tough.
Who has the voice? The moves? The nerve to be Andrew Lloyd Webber's next leading lady? This is Over the Rainbow. There's going to be more twists and turns than a Kansas tornado. The panel are here with their brains. Our final nine Dorothys have plenty of courage. And the Lord has a great big heart. I feel like I'm in Iceland. But who will win that life-changing role? Performing Ease On Down the Road, please welcome our final nine Dorothys! Our final nine, Jenny, Danny, Sophie, Danielle, Stephanie, Jessica, Emily, Steph, and Lauren. Week. And in the next hour, our final nine will be put through their paces. At stake is the once-in-a-lifetime chance to play Dorothy in the West End. And none of them want to slip up tonight. We know the role of Dorothy won't be Bronte's. Last week, she had to hand back her shoes after the Lord was forced to make an agonizing choice between her and Lauren in the sing-off. Bronte Gate proves that nobody is safe, and in tomorrow's results show, the two Dorothys with the fewest votes will face the agony of singing for survival. Here to help you call the casting shots, we have our panel of experts. Shooting from the lip, legendary actress Sheila Hancock. He sings, he dances, acting on the storm in Albert Square, John Partridge. And the lady with a finger on the pulse and a ring on her finger, newly engaged Charlotte Church. Congratulations to you, Charlotte. Everyone loves a church wedding. And last but not least, the man with a magic touch the wizard could only dream of. It's our very own Lord, Andrew Lloyd Webber. Now, Andrew, last week, such a tough decision for you because you said that both Lauren and Bronte were in your kind of personal top five. How tough a call was it?
I mean, it was ridiculously tough, really. But the good news about Bronte is that she's had a fantastic week, and I think we can reveal that she's gone for a couple of auditions, which I think she's likely to get one of them. But I think even better is that she's got her place at stage school, which is what I think she needs. What we need. You see, last week when I said, look, Dorothy was a little bit too young for it, and I know that, of course, the role of Dorothy is a very young role. She's 12 years old in the original movie. But she has to have stamina, and I think what Bronte needs right now is the training that will give her the stamina to be able to do 8 shows a week. And I think all of us know that that's what you really have to do for the theatre. But my goodness, we've got a musical director caught in volcanic dust.
Yes.
So, this shows that we're a live show, which has got real talent. And, you know, a band tonight who's picking themselves up with Mike Dixon, who's coming to stand in for us tonight. Well done, thank you.
Welcome to the
family. We're live.
Thank you very much, Andrew. Now, later in the show, our potential leading ladies will be performing the West Side Story classic, America. It is sensational. But first, let's meet our first two Dorothys. Limbering up and ready for action, it's Danny Rayner and Sophie Evans.
Danny, I thought that was brilliant.
Lovely vocal.
I really got all of your emotion.
That's just what I wanted, and I'm so happy.
I can't believe that I'm here performing live every Saturday night. I mean, it was touch and go as to whether I was actually going to be able to go to the audition in the first place because my parents didn't want me to go.
Our daughter is a very determined young lady, so she, unbeknownst to us, applied for Oh the Rainbow, but didn't tell us until a week before her audition.
I'm just currently studying for my AS levels.
It was tough to say, yes, you can kind of effectively leave school, forget your AS levels for now, and pursue your dream in London, but I think she was born to be on stage, actually. She just loves to perform. She just comes alive. And when we see that, we know that that's what she has to do.
Very proud. Very proud indeed.
I know it was a really tough decision for Mum and Dad to let me go into this, but I'm having the time of my life, and I'm so glad that they did.
You had two boy dancers with you in that performance, and I found myself looking at them rather than you.
I've had bad comments, really, actually, on the last 2 weeks.
You struggled tonight, but I'm going to put that down to nerves.
Who is not Dorothy? Sophie.
It's just frustrating because I felt as if I did a good performance.
Perhaps he just doesn't like me as a performer, but I've got to be able to change his mind.
The opportunity came sooner than she expected when John made a surprise visit to training.
You came out on that first show and you had bags of personality, and all I'm here to do today is to pull this performance out of you. There was a part of me that was thinking, have you got it in you or haven't you?
Anyone trying to find
ask the audience, isn't anybody trying to find me?
Somebody come take me home.
Think of home. Okay, Dorothy wants to get home. Yeah. You okay?
Yeah.
Are you sure you're okay? You're doing so well.
You know, I did get a bit emotional, but it was just relief and they were happy tears.
When you feel it, we can't help but feel it.
It's exactly what I needed. I feel that I'm going to totally rock it on Saturday now.
Yay! Isn't that better?
Let's hope so. Okay, you'll be able to vote for your favourite Dorothy at the end of the show. So don't even think about calling now.
Alright.
And if you're a satellite or cable viewer and fancy singing along with our girls, just press your ruby red button and hey presto, the wizard will grant your wish. It is that simple, isn't it?
It is. I don't have to say George, Dave or Nick or anything next week, do I?
No.
Or that red button?
I don't understand. I'll watch this on iPlayer and then I'll get it. Let's bring on the Dorothys. Up first, hoping to go over the rainbow, it's Danny! This headstrong 16-year-old is singing One Night Only and intends to give the performance of her life. Following closely behind, it's Sophie! Our Welsh Dorothy is hoping to swap the valleys for the Emerald City with her performance of I'm With You. Could Danny or Sophie be your Dorothy? Don't ask me. Here's Danny!
Oh.
ever. The only trouble is I really don't have the time. So let's forget about chances. This one night I will be. You took up my devotion. You want the soul.
You did a ballad and you got wonderful comments from the judges. This week, more of like a diva, Danny. Which one are you more comfortable with?
I don't think I'm a diva at all, but I mean, I just love coming out every week and giving something new because I've had, you know, really contrasting songs, and it's been such a fun week with the male dancers, and it's just been...
Steady, Danny.
Just like, it's just, I've had so much fun, you know, being a kind of different person, so I just hope I can, you know, be someone else next week.
And Sophie, we saw in the film there that, you know, John worked with you this week. Do you think he'll be proud of you after that performance?
Well, I hope so, because I put my absolute heart and soul into that performance, and after the session, I really felt that, you know, my confidence built and I can reach notes, and I didn't think I'd be able to reach, so, you know, I'm really grateful.
All right, well, let's check in with the panel. I'll start with you, John. I mean, you are focusing on movement and presentation this week. How do you think they did?
Well, obviously, there wasn't much movement in those two performances, so what I was looking for was connection with the audience and connection with the lyric, and I've got to tell both of you ladies that you were sensational, and you did me proud.
Danny, I'd like to start with you, if I may. You had 9 boy dancers, yet you came out centre front, you planted yourself, and you sold it. I knew what you were feeling and what you were thinking. It was really your strongest performance for me to date. And Sophie, I could just give you the biggest hug right now. We worked a lot together this week on really committing. You believed it, and I believed you. And I'm here to tell you, you're not going home after that performance, and you could still be Dorothy.
You've turned John around, Sophie. Let's see what Charlotte has to say.
Sophie, I love that performance. I think you sometimes you push your voice right at the top, but you've got all of those notes absolutely spot on. You've got a beautiful tone of voice. I thought you started off a little bit shaky, and you really grew into it. I really believed you. You looked like, you know, desperate, and, you know, I completely got all of the emotion you were trying to give, so I thought that was a great performance. And Danny, what I love about you is that you're not self-conscious at all. I feel like when you're singing, you are giving me everything you have, like, and I really love that about you. Be careful, your voice does tend to get nasal sometimes, so just be careful. I've said it to you in the past, so just be careful. You really must listen as soon as it's coming out of your mouth. Just listen to it straight away, and you can change the tone halfway through a note. So, yeah, just be careful of that.
I don't think that was nasal at all.
I thought some notes were. Generally, it was a nice noise, but occasionally, as soon as you hit a certain vowel sometimes, it can get a little bit nasal, so just be careful of that. But apart from that, 2 really great performances.
All right. Sheila, what did you think?
I thought they were both great. I thought, I'm going to be picky. As I always am. Sophie, I thought that was a real breakthrough for you. I long to see you do a humorous song. I hope the next one you're given, we can see that red head bouncing around and have a bit of fun, because you're always a bit intense, but you had to be with that number. Danny, you didn't quite make me understand what the number was about. I mean, as a pop song, it worked fantastic, and the audience were clapping along and everything, and I think that maybe slightly misled you. I mean, the number, as I understand it, is about a girl who is saying she doesn't want to commit, she's all for one night stand, which is hardly a Dorothy thing, really. And it really isn't for your age group either, but then I'm a silly old whatever. But I thought you made a good crack at it, but I would have liked much more light and shade in the number to clarify what the story was about. But having said that, I thought it was great.
All right, thanks, Sheila. Andrew, big ask from 2 of our youngest Dorothys. How did they do?
I mean, that's very interesting because, of course, we're not just a singing contest. And I'd like to ask John something, because you've worked with the girls this week.
Yes.
Out of the two of them, I'm going to say something that may be a little bit strange, but I sense that, you know, that you actually have music within you. I'm not sure, Danny, that you necessarily move with music, but I'd like to ask John about this, because we're not talking about our two strongest dancers, are we?
We're not, but Danny's performance was confident tonight. It wasn't self-conscious, and okay. She has in the past looked slightly self-conscious, and I just feel that Sophie...
Which is a big breakthrough.
Which is a big...
And last Sophie... week, she was superb in doing Home. Yeah. I mean, she was absolutely wonderful.
But there was no choreography in it.
No.
But you see, this is where it's getting really interesting now, because we are now talking about dance, and next week we're going to be talking about purely singing and acting again. It's really now about getting the whole package together, because you can't just be Dorothy in isolation. It's got to be, you know, not just you could sing it wonderfully, or you could. It's got to be, can we believe in you, and can you really move and move with the music?
All right, thank you very much, Andrew. Remember, one of our Dorothys must leave the competition for good in tomorrow's results show. If you want to keep your favourite in the running, you'll need to vote for her when lines open at the end of the show. Here's the number you'll need, 09011-2122. Then add 01 for Danny, or if you want to see Sophie star in the West End, add 02. Please don't call now, as your vote won't count and you may be charged. Our next hopeful, dreaming to be a Dorothy, had a nightmare last week when she was in the bottom 2. She was saved by the Lord, but she's feeling the pressure. It's Lauren Samuels.
Don't tell me what it's all.
You need to be careful. You're very confident, which is great, but sometimes it can come across as a bit arrogant.
I was devastated. Why is it so hard to talk when you're upset? To have a comment like that from Charlotte was really hard, yeah. I come across so confident, I know that I do, but inside, I'm not as thick-skinned as I let on. You know, I am just a 22-year-old girl trying to, you know, do really well in this competition.
Lauren, you are in the bottom 2. My eyes
are dry. I'm going to save Lauren.
It's like a bittersweet thing. I wanted to be happy, but I just couldn't. I couldn't feel it. My dream was nearly ripped away from me by literally an inch. It's going to be really tough this week, but you know, being in the bottom 2 made me realise how much I want this competition and this role.
Determined to stay in the competition and make more friends of Dorothy, it's Lauren! The 22-year-old from Leicestershire is performing Sway. But will she sway you to vote for her? Could she be your Dorothy? In your hands, here's Lauren!
Dancers may be on the floor, dear, but my eyes will see only you. Only you have that magic technique. When we sway, I go weak. Sway me, make me, thrill me, hold me, bend me, ease me. You have
in the bottom two, saved by the Lord. Do you think you'll have done enough to win the audience back?
Well, it's definitely been the toughest of all the weeks for me. But, you know, I've just come out here tonight and I've put a brave face on, like my mum always says, and I've tried to do my best. It feels like a comeback performance, you know. I just feel like I've just had to give it my all, and I really hope it's enough.
Well, let's find out. Charlotte, you warned Lauren last week about that difference between confidence and arrogance. How are you feeling about it this week?
You're just unbelievable. Like, you completely smouldered your way through that whole performance, and I just really, really hope and pray that people do vote for you because your voice is so special and a massive fan.
Sheila.
I thought it was a really, I think the word is elegant performance. The way you came down those stairs without looking at them, that alone was a triumph. Well done, Lauren. Excellent, excellent, because it's so difficult. I know you were gutted last week and you really did it. Well done.
And John.
I just want to say to you, Lauren, it's okay to be confident. Confidence is a good thing. Obviously, you've got the voice, and you've just proved tonight that you're a great dancer as well. So for me, you're still the full package.
Excellent. All right. The panel loved it. Andrew, obviously, Lauren's standing here because you decided to save her.
And the good news is that you didn't do all those sort of knowing gestures that you did last week, you know, and you're actually much more fun with it. I thought a really good performance. I think your best yet.
Congratulations, Lauren. Well, that's what Andrew thinks, but it's what you think that will ultimately decide who becomes Dorothy. If you want Lauren to stay out of tomorrow night's sing-off, here's the number for later. 090-11-21-22, then add 03 when lines open at the end of the show. Three Dorothys down and six more to come, including Steph, Jenny, Jessica and Danielle. Plus, our Dorothys put on a show-stopping performance as they go West Side Story. Our next two Dorothys had mixed fortunes last week. One was panned by the panel, one was praised. It's Emily Fleming and Stephanie Davis.
A bit pitchy in places.
I don't think you've completely got your voice under control yet.
I disagree that the voice is where I need to put the wig. But this is a tough competition. You're always going to get negative comments.
Who is not Dorothy?
Because the vocal just wasn't strong enough on the night, Emily.
The voice is there. I've trained, like, I've had lessons. I'm, you know, I can sing. I'm just appreciating being here and getting this far. The public have faith in me. They want to see more from me.
Emily, you could still be Dorothy. Congratulations!
I've just got so much more to give, and it is quite frustrating knowing that, you know, I haven't wowed the judges yet, but I just pray to get better and better, and I will wow them.
I absolutely love singing the song last week. I've been waiting for ages to show everyone at home and the judges that I have got a different side to me.
You did it beautifully, really well, with real intelligence.
I just love your tone of voice. I think it was perfect. I think it was the performance of the night for me.
Wow.
Before I went on to do my song, I was constantly worrying. I always do. Everyone says, like, you know, oh, you're always really confident and stuff, but deep down, I'm always, like, I'm a really big worrier. A few years ago, I took a bit of a knock, confidence-wise. Someone told me that I wasn't good enough, and I believed them. I kind of just didn't believe that I could do it anymore. And no matter how hard I tried, it just wasn't there. And I didn't, like, sing and dance for a year. Now, I just know that I love performing, and when I get onto that stage, you know, something clicks and I feel at home. I'm never going to doubt myself again. I've got 100% faith in myself now. I can't wait to get out there and do my thing.
OK, Dorothy, do your thing. Waiting in the wings, it's Emily. Our Geordie Lass is singing Moon River, which will sail through to next week. Hot in her heels is Stephanie. Our Liverpool Lovely is going all Latino with her rendition of Let's Get Loud by Jennifer Lopez. Could Emily or Stephanie be your Dorothy? I won't stop asking until you tell me. Here's Emily. Hey! Wow! All right, ladies. I mean, the competition is really hotting up now.
Yes.
So is it just like work, or is there any fun to be had being a Dorothy?
There is fun. We do have a laugh.
We do. We have a laugh when we get home and stuff and in training and doing the pike. No. But, yeah, we have a laugh. It's really good, but it is a lot of hard work. You know,
we just sleep, you know, when we get home, it's sleep, eat, sleep,
prepare for the next day.
And train the next day. It's
all right, well, brace yourselves. We're panel bound. Sheila, your comments.
Well, that was wonderful, Stephanie. You're back on your safe ground. And I'm so glad that last week you did smile so beautifully, because you've shown you can do both. And you move like a dream. It's lovely. It's lovely. Very pleasure. I've not... I have to say, as far as interpretation, I haven't the slightest idea what the number was about, but never mind. It looked nice. Emily, that was great, but I could have done more with understanding what the song's about. It happens to be one of my favourite songs, but I didn't quite understand why that gentleman was there, but I'm sure you did. But I thought it was about Huckleberry Finn and friendship and rivers and things and aspiration, and I didn't quite get that from you. But it was pretty, and your voice sounded very pretty.
All right, John, who delivered for you?
Well, Emily, I have to say, I just didn't get it. And Sheila said you probably knew what you were doing, but I'm not sure whether you did, because I just didn't understand who you were singing to and what you were singing for. You also had this little waltz section over here. You didn't look at the boy. You didn't connect with him. So then when you pulled away, I didn't understand why you were pulling. She didn't look at him.
She did. I saw her look at him.
Eyes.
She did. She looked
she did
him.
Not look
I saw,
at him in
I
the eyes.
Look
I could see
him.
So you didn't look at him. So I, therefore, I didn't understand why you were pulling away. I just didn't understand it. I also felt that that was a number that you didn't have much movement in and you didn't sound supported vocally. Stephanie Davis, my little firecracker, I thought it was another solid, sensational performance from you. If I had to give you one critique, you don't always have to throw so much energy at it.
So
try and find a bit of light and shade in there. You know when you can pull back from it, because that'll help you with your breath control. But it was another great performance.
And very quickly, Charlotte.
Emily, you have found your vocal control. I thought that's a really exposing song. There's a lot of long notes, a lot of low notes. I thought you sang it really, really nicely. I got the whole story. Maybe it is about friendship, but that could have been about friendship. I completely got the whole story. Stephanie, you're awesome. That's all I've got to say. You're absolutely
all
awesome.
All right. Over to Andrew. What do you make of those?
Well, our problem is we've got such very talented girls, so I'm going to have to come straight to the point and be a little bit blunt here. Emily, I think there was a reason why we didn't put you into the top 10 originally, and I've got to say that I don't think that you are vocally that secure. It is a difficult song to sing, Moon River, very, very hard, but, you know, I just worry about you, honestly, in a 2,500-seater theatre and it's 8 shows a week, I do. I've got to say it. Stephanie, I think you did something extraordinary tonight. I mean, you were a wonderful mover, a wonderful dancer. But the interesting thing is Emily is possibly our best mover, would you say, John? I think you probably are. So don't give up yet, Emily.
All right. Thank you very much, Andrew. Now, Dorothy is safe from the sing-off. So to keep your favourite out of danger, here's the number to call when lines open later. 09011-2122, then at 04 for Emily. Or if you think Stephanie deserves to be Dorothy, add 05. Okay, that's 5 Dorothys down, 4 more wedding nervously in the wings. Remember, they'll be pulling out all the stops when they give an explosive West Side Story performance later. And I know, Andrew, you're really looking forward to that, aren't you?
Well, I think so, because, I mean, the fantastic thing is that all of these kids are doing more, and as we all know in the West End, we wouldn't ask a West End company to do as much as these girls are going to do tonight and tomorrow night. You just wouldn't do it. I mean, we would say 5-6 weeks rehearsal. They're learning all these new songs every week, and it's quite extraordinary. And therefore, that's why I think that America is going to be a defining moment in the history of our competitions, if they can pull that off. So good luck. Please do it for me.
All right, Andrew. Now, in the musical, Dorothy and her companions overcome a series of obstacles to reach the Emerald City. Let's meet the next two contenders, hoping to overcome everything we throw at them. Steph Fearon and Jenny Douglas.
Ladies, take note. That was absolutely fantastic.
Oh, I'm so happy. I'm
really
happy.
It's nice that my family are there for me. My parents have given me all the inspiration to do this.
She's worked so hard, and now she's just trying to go for her dream.
She does proud of
them. It sounds really corny, but they're, like, the biggest inspiration.
My mum had a hit with Let Me Be Your Fantasy in the 90s. Let me be your fantasy. And my dad
and was in Galaxy in the 80s, and he had some hits as well.
Coming here, strangely enough, takes us back. Yeah. This reminded Top of the Pops.
Yeah.
And I thought, you know, this is our girl here now. Yeah. It really does set the heart
flutter. We're really proud. We're
so proud.
They know exactly what it's like to go out there on stage, you know, singing in front of millions of people. It's so bizarre that I'm doing it now. And I said to my dad yesterday, I was like, are you jealous that I'm more famous than you now? He was like, yeah, actually.
Jenny, lovely tone throughout, and you just sang it really, really beautifully.
Each week, my comments, they're so amazing, and it's making me believe in myself so much more.
Your pitching was immaculate. It was a great performance.
Andrew Lloyd Webber said that was pitch perfect, so hello.
It's also a lot of pressure, though, at the same time, because you want to keep those good comments coming. I've just been told that this week's choreography week. I'm literally the worst dancer in the competition. I think I look great, and then I catch sight of myself in the mirror and I'm like, oh my god, what are you doing? Maintaining that standard that I've sort of set for myself, I think I've got a funny feeling it might just drop, you know, this week. Dorothy doesn't really dance, she just does a wee skip and a jump and a hop, and you know, I can do that.
Let's see, shall we? Going all out for your votes, it's Steph! The 21-year-old barber from London is performing Out Here on My Own for Fame. Up next is our McDorothy, Jenny! Our superstar is taking on the Diana Ross classic, Ride a Fool, Fall in Love. Good step for Jenny be your Dorothy. Here's Steph!
Fit in, make believe in, it's hard alone, out here on my own. We're always proving who we are, always reaching for that rising star. Guide me far and shine me home, out here on my own. When I'm down and feeling blue, I close my eyes so I can be with you. Oh, baby, I can't be thrown out here on my own.
We were talking earlier about confidence and how it is a, you know, it can be a real key to a performance. How confident do you guys feel in your own ability when you have to do a big number like that?
Well, personally, I feel confident in my ability, but then you come to the day of the live shows, it's like, you know, it's hard to not let your nerves take over in a way, isn't it? And you just have to just put on a brave face and give 100%.
I think as well, like, the main thing is, it was such a shock, Bronte going last week, and I think you've got to just come out every week and just have as much fun as possible, because you never know when it's going to be your last night.
Oh, true. Let's go over to the panel. John, very different performances there. You know, Jenny had a big dance number, Steph just by herself. How do we compare those?
Well, Steph, last week you dazzled us with your choreographic skills, and this week you dazzled us with your acting ability. That was absolutely wonderful. Sincere and honest. Jenny, this is a difficult one for me with you because I'm starting to think that maybe you're faking it. And I'm not looking for a girl that fakes it. I'm looking for a girl that can actually do it.
Charlotte?
Steph, I think you're a triple threat. I think you can act, you can dance, and you can sing. The one thing I'd say is be careful of your vibrato, which is the wobbly stuff in your voice. Sometimes maybe it's nerves, it can get a little overpowering, so just be careful to hold that back. And Jenny, the overall performance was pretty good, but your voice got really nasally there, really, really nasally. And I know it doesn't have to all the time, because Songbird was beautiful all the way through last week, so listen out.
And very briefly, Sheila.
I thought Steph was absolutely beautiful, very deeply felt and simple and lovely. Jenny, I don't care whether you can dance or not. Just have fun with it, like you were in rehearsal. You could have gone further in just thinking, oh, to hell with the choreography, I'll just have a laugh.
Don't listen to her. Don't listen to her. Andrew, what did you think?
Oh, I don't know. I would listen to Sheila about that. I would say to hell with the choreography from that one. I mean, you did extremely well with it. A tricky one, though, to do. You know, Steph, I would just say one thing to you. I think you're immensely talented. I only worry about whether or not, in fact, this Dorothy is the right one for you. It's only about the role, not about your talent.
All right, but remember, one of our Dorothys must go home in tomorrow night's results show. If you don't want Steph or Jenny to take a one-way ticket to the moon, you'll need to vote for them when lines open later. The number to call is 090-11-2122. Then add 06 for Steph, and if you want to see Jenny skipping up the Elibic Road, then add 07. Don't call now, your vote won't count. It's not just Dorothy we're looking for. In tomorrow's results show, we'll see more happy hounds hoping to play Toto. Oh, there were tails a wagging everywhere. Such was the excitement.
Dancing, are we dancing? Five.
Yes!
Oh, so cool.
Brilliant!
Touch that.
Good boy!
In all our combined years of dog training, this is unique.
Bang!
Oh! Thomas Cook was born with a hairlipping cleft palate. He survived being put to sleep and he works with special needs children.
We think Missy could be Toto.
No.
Do you think Andrew knows what's going to hit him?
Oh, yeah. Especially that one.
You will cry. Let's meet our next two Dorothys desperate to get their hands on those ruby slippers. It's Jessica Robinson and Danielle Hope.
Performance. I didn't feel like I had nailed it.
I was disappointed.
There was no truth and no honesty in that performance at all.
It's devastating getting completely ripped for your performance. I genuinely thought I was going to be in the sing-off.
You can still be Dorothy, well done.
So it was such a shock for Bronte to go. That just broke my heart. She's like my best friend. I've lost my best friend in here now. And I also miss my best friend from home, Rebel. My little dog wearing a Jess t-shirt. I love him and I miss him so much.
Unbeknownst to Jess, though, her mom has brought Rebel down to cheer her up.
I had a few bad comments last week, and I mean, like anybody, you'd feel a bit downhearted. But this has just made me 10 times happier.
My dog!
I feel like I can go on to Saturday and really fight for it again.
Just a little girl.
Nobody's going to look over you after that performance because that was your best performance to date.
It's really bizarre that I started musical theatre quite late on because, you know, I was so shy and everyone used to call me the Victorian child because I was definitely seen and not heard.
from primary school. In my final year, I was forced to do a year six leaving play, and we did Grease, and I played Rizzo, and I was like, no, please don't make me, please don't make me. You can't make me stand on that stage. And then in high school, a lady called Helen Main sort of took me under her wing.
To see Danielle growing confidence over the past 5 or 6 years as a teacher, as a mentor, and then to look at her on stage on a Saturday night is just absolutely amazing.
I can't believe I've gone from, you know, sitting in the corner with books at primary school and, you know, not wanting to get on the stage at all to now being on telly on a Saturday night. What? You know, where did that come from? That just doesn't happen, does it?
Well, it's happening tonight. Raring to go, it's Jessica Robinson. Our dog-loving Dorothy is singing Crazy Little Thing Called Love. We will rock you. Following her is Danielle. Our Mancunian Marvel is hoping to wow you with her performance of Could It Be Magic? Could Jessica or Danielle be Dorothy? They think so. Here's Jessica. I mean, this has been such an intense week with all the work you've had to do. How are you guys coping?
Oh, great, actually. I mean, I come away and I'm normally like the wild child at home, go parties and everything. But we've come here and we've had to like go home, eat, bath, bed.
Yeah, it's such a good stamina test. Like, yeah, really, like you guys saying before, like you wouldn't have to learn this amount of material in this short time. So it's been really good, a really good stamina test.
Let's see if it was worth it. We'll go to the panel. Charlotte.
Well, basically, Jess, I think that you own the stage, like you completely own the stage. I had to watch you. I wish you would have bluesed it up a bit. It's kind of a bluesy little song, so you could have bluesed it up a little bit more. And Danielle, it was good, but the top notes, when you're singing so high, you should definitely colour it with a bit of vibrato, which is the wobbly stuff, like I said earlier. Otherwise, it tends to sound a bit shouty, but otherwise, it was a complete performance.
All right, Charlotte was pleased. And Sheila?
Steph, the choreography was so complicated, I felt that you weren't really right on top of it because of the time. Danielle, I want you to love the camera more. What you do is so truthful and so wonderful, but regard the camera as your friend rather than an intrusion, because only that way will you get to the people at home. Imagine somebody sitting in a dark bed sit wanting to be told you're in love. Okay.
All right, just to confirm, you meant Jessica when you were talking.
Yes. I didn't. Yes, Jessica. Okay. No. I meant.
Yeah, no.
I meant
earlier Danielle. You meant Jessica. When you were talking about Jessica, you meant Jessica. Yes,
I did.
Yeah, fine.
Jessica, I really wanted to love it, but I'm sorry, my love. I just didn't. I found the choreography laboured. It looked like really hard work, and I didn't really enjoy it at all.
I think it looks slick.
Danielle, whilst I love the performance, I feel like I've seen it before. I feel like you found what you're good at, and you're sticking with it. You need to change it up a little bit. Take a risk.
Okay.
What sort of song would you like her to sing?
Something joyous.
I don't mean the song. I actually mean her performance. I feel like the performance has been the same for the last four songs. They've all been different songs, but I feel that she's approaching it with the same sentiment, and I just want to see something else from you.
She's approaching it with truth.
Something a bit more joyous, I think.
All right, well, let's see what Andrew thinks. Our final two ladies.
Well, I'm a little bit confused by you guys now, actually, because I have to say, Jessica, that if I was casting Funny Girl, that wonderful Barbara Streisand musical, I think I would have you high on the list, because I think you use your facial expressions extraordinarily, and I think you do actually work the camera very well. I was looking a little bit around. Of course, I'm seeing you live, but you were doing two things. You were working the room, and you were also working, the television. I thought that was fantastic. And Danielle, you see, I think you are a very, very remarkable performer. I think you can come out of your shell a little bit more. I think there is further to go. But do you know what? I can't wait, really, to work with you girls myself, because there's something fabulous about both of you.
Wow. High praise from the Lord, but that's his view. It's your votes that will determine who is safely through to next week. If you want to keep Jessica or Danielle out of danger, here's the number to call shortly. 09011-2122, then add 08 for Jessica. Or if you think Danielle has what it takes to be Dorothy, add 09. But remember, do not call until I say so. Them is the rules. Still to come, our final nine perform the West Side Story classic, America. And if our Dorothys have inspired you to belt out a few show tunes yourself, then you're in luck. Early next month, at venues all around the country, Over the Rainbow events will be held. A selection of our Dorothys will be singing their hearts out, along with I'd Do Anything winner Jodie Pringer. Go to bbc.co.uk/Dorothy for all the details. Now, tonight, we're showcasing our Dorothy's singing and dancing talents, so we've decided to put the girls firmly through their paces, a real West End workout. They want fame. Well, fame costs, and right here is where they start paying.
OK, girls, so this morning we're going to be learning the group number, which is America from West Side Story. OK?
Yeah. I like to be in America.
I'm so excited. I've done West Side Story three times before, and I'm kind of in love with West Side Story.
I am not a West Side Story buff at all. I haven't even actually seen it.
I love the music for me, but I just don't know the story.
I mean, we are all focusing on our solo numbers, but this group number is still a massive deal this week.
I've been quite easy on the girls up to this point. My aim is to make them look the best they can on each show, but with this number, they're all doing the same choreography. They've all got to pull out the stops.
I think this dance number is definitely the hardest one, like, I've ever, ever done.
It is a tricky one. I've had dance training, and I'm still struggling a little bit, so... Yeah, I feel sorry for the girls that haven't danced before.
Everybody's got the same choreography, so, you know, if you make a mistake, it's going to stand out massively.
We've each got a boy each, which is really fun.
I was not distracted at all. Purely just getting to know the other people we're sharing the stage with.
Such an exciting number, you know, it's like the judges are watching, so it's like, you know, trying to say, look what I can do.
Each girl now has to pull focus. They have to show to the judges that they can lead a West End ensemble.
If you want to shine on your line, you've got to get through, you've got to push through.
It's a really competitive routine, you know, we're all kind of fighting to get to the front.
I guess it's kind of just like the competition, you know, like the Dorothy's, like, all fighting over the spotlight.
I'm going to steal the show, I'm just going to steal the whole number.
It's every Dorothy for themselves in this song. Yeah, let the battle begin.
Now, Andrew, we've seen the girls work so hard this week. I mean, how important are these group performances that they do?
Well, they're very important because when you're voting, you've got to look at the girls in these performances to see what the all-round quality is that we're looking for. Just remember, I mean, they are holding a stage in a huge theatre. They've got to be able to fill that.
And I know that America from West Side Story, it's one of your favourites. And why is it such a good song to show off?
Well, I'm going to put it this way. I wouldn't have dared to do this in any of the last shows that we've done because we wouldn't have had the girls who could have even remotely got near performing it. It's one of the most tough songs. Well, it probably is one of the most iconic dance numbers in the history of musical theatre from, I have to say, I think my favourite musical.
Oh, of all time? And, John, I mean, in terms of dance, how big is this challenge?
This is a huge challenge. I would just like to take this opportunity to thank our choreographer, Kevin Allen, for coming up with
you. Week
after week. Come on, ladies.
All right, thank you, John. Thank you, Andrew. Let's see which of our hopefuls stand out from the crowd. They all want to go to Kansas, but first they've got to conquer America. Our Dorothy's, everyone!
I like to be in America. Okay, by me in America. Everything free in America. For a small fee in America.
Buying on credit is so nice. Charged twice. I have my own washing machine. What do you have there to keep clean? Lots of new housing with more space.
Lots of doors slamming in our face.
I'll get a terrace apartment.
Get rid of your accent.
Oh. Life can be bright in America. If you can fight in America, life is all right in America. If you're all right in
Bravo. Back to Puerto Rico, everybody.
Oh, fantastic. But remember, tomorrow night, one of these girls must leave the competition for good. Also, you'll see how they all got on when John Partridge decided to get them into step for their next mission. But who had perfect posture and who went head over heels?
I am wearing heels today.
He's such a natural in heels.
Step forward. Good, Danny. Better side. You're good on the right, bad on the left.
Basically, I run like an elephant.
Hello, girls.
I wouldn't say I'm the most graceful person, but I'm working on it.
More of that tomorrow. Okay, everyone, get set to pick up the phone. The lines are now open. They'll stay open until 9 p.m. tonight. Vote now to keep your favourite out of tomorrow night's sing-off. Calls cost 25p for BT Landline. Other operators may vary, and calls for mobiles will be considerably higher. 14p from each call will go towards the BBC Performing Arts Fund. And if you're under 18, remember to get the bill payer's permission. Full terms and conditions are available at bbc.co.uk/Dorothy. Still not decided who's your favourite? Here's a reminder of this evening's performances and those all-important numbers. After then, as your vote won't count and you may still be charged. We're back again tomorrow when John puts our girls through their paces in this week's mission. Plus, don't miss another of our Dorothy musical mashups. We are so down with the kids. Plus, the search for Toto continues, but which dogs will do the business? One more Dorothy must go home. Who will it be? Find out when 9 become 8. That's tomorrow night at the earlier time of 6:15 here on BBC One and BBC HD. Good night, everyone.